Remember that we define the definite integral ab f of x dx as the area between the graph of the function and the x-axis, something like this. If this is my a, this is my b, then the integral is this area. If the function is negative, we subtract from the area. In some cases, you can calculate these integrals by simple geometric arguments. For example, if the function f is a linear function, then we can always figure out the area and the value of the integral. So let's look at another example. Here, I want to find the integral of the function f of x equal to x squared between 0 and 1. And the x squared function looks something like this. When x is 1, the function returns y equal to 1. Okay, in this case, it's not that simple to just figure out this area by geometric arguments. Then you have two choices. Either you can learn how to calculate these kind of integrals by learning about primitive functions, or you can learn how to calculate these integrals using some software. And this plug is about the latter. So you can find a lot of software which will calculate these types of integrals exactly. One such software is online and free, and it's called Wolfram Alpha. So to compute this integral, you simply type integrate x squared from 0 to 1. X hat 2 means the same thing as x raised to 2 or x squared. Wolfram Alpha will then write down the definite integral. It'll give you the answer. That's 1/3. It will give a visual representation. We see again the function here, f of x equal to x squared. And Wolfram Alpha has marked the area in a light blue color. So using Wolfram Alpha, we found 0 to 1 x squared dx is equal to 1/3. And if we think about it, that sort of makes sense, because if I look at the graph of the x squared function like this, and I look at the graph of the x function like this, I know that the area here under the x function, that's just a triangle, it's 1/2. So it kind of makes sense that this area here should be 1/3. Keep in mind that when you ask Wolfram Alpha to calculate an integral, you always write integrate, you write the function, you do not write the x, but you write the limits using the notation from a number to another number. Let's look at one more example. Let's look at the function f of x equal to e to the minus x. If you like, you can use Wolfram Alpha also to make a plot of a function, and then you would just simply write plot e to the minus x. Here, I'm only interested in positive x values, and the graph of the function looks something like this. E to the 0 is 1, and then it decreases quite quickly towards 0 as x increases. So let's investigate this integral for various values of c and see what happens to this area as c increases. So here I've done the integral of e to the minus x from 0 to 5. You can write e to the minus x using e and the hat symbol as before, but it's much better to use the exp function for e to something. It makes it simpler to write. So If I do this integral, I get the answer 0.9936. Now let's try to increase the right-hand limit to, let's say, 10. That gives me 0.99995. So it seems like the bigger I make the right-hand limit, the closer this integral is to 1. That may sound a little bit counterintuitive because I'm making the base here larger and larger and larger. But the point, of course, is that the height becomes smaller and smaller. So when I increase the right-hand side limit, the total area doesn't increase that much. So what you can do, actually, you can tell Wolfram Alpha to calculate the integral from 0 to infinity. That would then be the limit of this area as you keep on going further and further to the right. In Wolfram Alpha, the infinity symbol is EMFTY. Hit enter, and I get exactly 1. You can see that Wolfram Alpha put this little infinity symbol at the top of the integral. And in this case, it doesn't offer to draw a diagram of the function, which kind of makes sense because now I want x to go all the way to infinity, and it's a little bit difficult to draw that. So we have to make do with the actual value of the integral, which is 1.